I just like to show you how much of an opportunity exists right now, because we are in a recession that has been caused artificially by shutting down most of the economy in a lot of different countries, right?
You're listening to Business Lunch with Roland Frasier. This is your seat at the table.
That's really hard on a lot of businesses. And so most businesses sell for a multiple of either their profit or their revenue. And what happens is that the multiples that are used when you get into a recessionary time like this are lower. But historically, every single time across every recession in history, I think there's 42 in the United States since the United States is founding, and I believe 18 in the last 100 years. But these multiples, they increase as the recessions pass. So our goal is to ideally acquire when things are inexpensive, and then to think about selling when we get closer to the peak. Now, you don't have to time that perfectly or anything. It's just to show you that there's a great opportunity to acquire right now. So it's a lower multiple, but not only that, the profits of these businesses are lower right now. So that's what creates to me this giant opportunity that we're talking about here today. Okay, so a little bit too about my experience and my epic journey. This is something that I do all the time. I just closed a deal this week to acquire part of a company that's doing $50 million a year and $10 million in EBITDA without any money out of pocket. So this isn't something that I did 30 years ago and I'm just teaching about it now because I'm not doing deals. I'm doing deals all the time. And we've acquired quite a few companies during the crisis that's going on right now. So just a little bit about the history though. In the 80s, I was doing, I am old. Back in the 80s, I was doing manufacturing acquisitions using a technique called LBO, which is a leveraged buyout. And that is something that was super popular during the 80s. Then as things progressed, I was doing retail workouts, particularly in the restaurant business in the 90s. So that's basically the recession of the 80s. The opportunity for me was manufacturing, machine manufacturing in particular companies. In the 90s, it was retail workouts, primarily in the restaurant industry. In 2000, when the dot-com bust happened, and there were all of these companies that were tech companies that had received a lot of funding, and then just kind of the value disappeared, I was doing lots of reorganizations of those companies. And then as the Great Recession, we call it in the United States, 2007, 8, and 9, when the subprime lending crisis all hit the fan and Lehman Brothers went out of business, there were tremendous opportunities to do roll-ups. And so I was doing quite a few real estate roll-ups during that time. And now we are in another recession and pretty much everything is on sale because everyone has been impacted by shutting down most of the economy in so many different countries. And so right now we're acquiring SaaS companies. In the last 30 days, we've acquired two SaaS companies. We're acquiring media, which I'll talk more specifically about, real estate, publishing companies, and companies that have MRR. MRR stands for monthly recurring revenue. This is revenue that comes in consistently month after month. Okay, now here's something to think about. Despite the downturn in the global economy, there's a lot of cash that's sitting on the table for M&A. Why do you care about that? Well, you might be in this just to acquire a company that will provide you with money and profits and distributions and things like that. That's cool. I'm in this game not just to acquire companies for that, but I also want to sell them. And so I just want you to know that should you decide that you actually want to get into this fun process of flipping companies, I flip companies like people flip houses, right? You hear a lot about that, flipping houses stuff, but you don't hear a lot about flipping companies. But there's a lot of money that is sitting on the sidelines that's available to buy companies that fit a certain criteria. But the first thing to think about is that there is about $2.5 trillion in private equity money. Private equity, that's just companies that are set up as a fund to buy and sell companies. So they have a very particular buying criteria that I'll share with you here in a second. But think about that, $2.5 trillion sitting on the sidelines in cash to buy these companies. And if you go into corporations, there's another $2.4 trillion there. So you're talking about $5 trillion US dollars that are sitting on the sidelines looking for deals to buy. Tremendous opportunity should you decide that you want to get into the flipping company game. Okay. Now, it was really good. The opportunity was really good before the crisis. And it has only gotten better as a result of everything that's going on in the world right now. The very first thing that I would like for you to think about is that there are, in the United States alone, 50 million baby boomers that will be retiring over the next 10 years. One thing also that I'd like to point out is that I cite everything I say. I like to support every statement that I make. I'm not going to make something up on the spot. They say, the joke is, they say 97% of all statistics are made up on the spot, right? I don't do that. So 50 million baby boomers, according to the Insurance Retirement Institute, retiring over the next 10 years. In addition to that, 12 million of those own businesses, right? And again, that's from Wealth Management Report. Now, that means that there's a lot of businesses that are going to be available to acquire. As a matter of fact, 4.5 million businesses in the United States alone, worth over $10 trillion, are going to be transitioning over the next 10 years. And last but not least, and this is really interesting and shows you where our opportunity is that only 20% of those businesses that go up for sale actually end up selling. And that's from Biz Buy Sell Insights. So think about that. This is just in the United States, and this is a global phenomenon, right? In the United States alone, though, 50 million baby boomers with 12 million businesses are going to be transitioning about 4.5 million of those businesses over the next 10 years, $10 trillion in value. And despite the fact that all of these people are going to want to sell, only 20%. So if we multiply this 4.5 million times 20%, that means only about 900,000 will sell traditionally, which means that the remainder, which I think if my math is right, is 3.6 million businesses are available for us to buy, for us to acquire, okay, using the creative things that we'll be talking here. So now is the best time ever. It's the best time ever. And what we're really doing is turning crisis into even more opportunity here. It's kind of fun when you think about crisis because it comes from the Greek word krisis, which means a turning point in a disease that will either result in recovery or death. And for a lot of business owners, this thing is going to result in the death of their business, right? But what we are intending to do is to help these businesses recover. So let's take a look real quick too at returns. To me, I like to think about my return on effort. What is our return on effort so that we're doing the things that are going to give us the greatest reward? Typically here in the United States right now, if you look at cash investments are very, very low. The interest rates are actually really, really low for returns on these things. And they're kind of trending down right now, right? If you had invested in the Standard & Poor 500, which is a stock index here in the United States, you might use FTSE or one of the other ones if you're international, that's about an 8% return. And real estate is going to traditionally return between 10 and 12%. But the returns when you're acquiring companies for no money out of pocket are actually infinite because you're investing $0, right? So your ROI is infinite there. But even if we were to buy traditionally companies, if we were going to do it the old-fashioned way of paying cash for them, you know, it's really going to average for you about a 44% annualized return on your money. So why would you buy versus starting up, because a startup is free, right? You just start it up. Whereas if you buy a business, and remember, we prefer to say acquire versus buy, because what we're really trying to do is acquire for no money out of pocket. But why would you buy versus starting up? Okay, so the first thing is just a lot less risk, right? You can imagine that it's less risk because it's already going, right? So a lot of startups fail, but not a lot of existing businesses that are acquired fail. So there's less risk. There are a whole lot more financing options. It's really hard to get funding for a startup. There's a very few ways of doing that, venture capital funds, angels, that kind of stuff. There's a ton of ways to acquire businesses that are already existing because there is less risk, right? That makes sense.